Hello.
Yeah. just a sign that I'm still alive. I got some scars, but I'm still alive. In spite of calamity, he still has a plan for me. It's working for me.
Worship the Lord. Let me hear your words of worship. Let me hear your words of worship. Come on, y'all, talk to him. Say, come.
You come from royalty.
It's an aristocratic.
The goal of the enemy
is to keep you from knowing who you are.
Don't know who.
your inner king. You were born to rule. And you need to know that
there is a king.
I know that some of you have been molested. I know that some of you have been struggling. I know that some of you have been talked about. I know that some of you have got lower self-esteem. But I came to tell you that there is a king. I know that some of you are struggling with addictions. I know that some of you are struggling with financial issues. I know that some of you don't feel like you're smart. You don't feel like you look good. You don't feel like you got what it takes. But I came to tell you that there's a king
in you.
I know you don't feel well. I know you don't think you look the part. I know that you don't think you got the skills. But I came to tell you that there is a king in you. Forget about what you've been through. You are a king.
There is a king.
Let the king rejoice. Let the king rejoice. You are successful. The king is living in you. The word is in you. Praise him because
there is a king.
Forever the head, never the tail.
How many people are encouraged tonight?
Not through with me yet. This life is only a test. Trials come and they go, but a word for you is hold on. Though the times seem to be harder, from the steps you took to get started, but if you only keep the we'll surely win this race. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. You are to thank you.
have seen where God has brought you from. They don't really understand it. They don't know your story.
You don't know my story.
You don't know
the things.
You don't know the things that I've come through.
You cannot imagine.
You cannot imagine.
About God, because even though I'm not perfect,
prophecy would never leave.
God's beauty. You brought your burdens.
Good morning. This is a day that God has made. We have come to rejoice and be glad in it. Certainly we come this morning to give God praise for all of the blessings that he had bestowed upon us. We come to celebrate the life of Cassandra Thomas Johnson, who has gone to be with the Lord. Aren't you happy about that? But the Bible said to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. So today we're going to dry our eyes and we're going to rejoice in our heart. Because the Bible said, blessed are the dead that dies in the Lord. So saith the Spirit, for they rest from thy labor. And so we know that she's resting now. But the joy of it is that one day we'll see her again. This is not the end of the story. Come on, talk to me. This is the beginning of a new life with the Lord. So let us stand. And we're going to sing Blessed Assurance. Jesus is mine. And following out this scripture, Reverend Brown, Reverend Bright will give the prayer.
Oh Lordy, blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a fall! Oh, there's salvation, virtue from God. Born of your Spirit. Come on, say it. This is my story. Watching and waiting, looking above, filled with his goodness. Oh, this is my, come on, let's say, this is my song, praising my Savior. Oh, every Christian ought to have a story. Oh, praising my Savior. Yeah. Oh, this is my story. This is my story.
the church. Amen. Come on, let's put them hands together. Give God a praise, because all of us ought to have a story, and all of us ought to have a song.
Good morning, Mount Zion, family and friends. As indicated in the program, I will be reading from the Old Testament and then the New Testament. Our Old Testament reading comes from Ecclesiastes chapter 3. I'm reading from the King James Version of the Bible. To everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away. Verse 11, He had made all things beautiful in his time. Also, he has set the world in their heart so that no man, no person can find out the work that God maketh from the beginning to the end. Our reading from New Testament is found in Revelation chapter 2, beginning at verse 8. And unto the angel of the church in Smyrna write, these things said he, said the first and the last, which was dead and is alive. I know thy works, and the tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan. Fear none of these things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word.
Pastor Jones opened up and said that we are going to dry our tears today. Amen. And we are going to celebrate life. I understand that Pastor is a compassionate man, and he understands that those tears aren't just going to fold up and dry up. It does take time. Weeping, it does endure for a night. It does endure for a night. You can't get to mourning until you go through mourning. It does endure for a night. And I must admit, this is rather personal. because when we started in this COVID thing, she was here welcoming us into this place. She was asking Reverend Bryant, where you going? But aren't we glad to know that you can't move from labor to reward unless you've done something? And so I would just like to say to you all as I go to this prayer of comfort, understand that God has moved her from labor to reward because she did something. And her time of doing that something is concluded. So let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are there many mansions. And if I go to prepare a place, I will come and get you and receive you into myself. All of us got to pass this way. Dear gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for your love and your kindness and your tender mercies. God, as we sit here, some with bowed down hearts, teared eyes, broken hearts, we recognize that you are a heart fixer and a mind regulator. We recognize, Father God, that at this time where families, sons, sisters, brothers, nieces, nephews, grandchildren, friends, brothers and sisters in Christ, pastors, deacons, all those that labored with this love, Father God, are here now to say, see you later. Not goodbye, but see you later. Because you promised, Father God, that we would see her later. So God, in the name of Jesus, as we come and celebrate this life, take us for just this moment, Father God, from tears to joy, Father God, from bowed down hearts to raised hands, Father God, from listening ears, Father God, to loud celebrating shouts, recognizing, Father God, that all things that you do well. You make no mistake. God, in the name of Jesus, let our praise team say something that encourages his heart, Father God. In the name of Jesus, Father God, lift up the spirit of our nursing ministry, Father God. In the name of Jesus, Father God, let, Father God, the pastor, Father God, minister a word, Father God, that might let us know, Father God, that it's not all dark, Father God, but there is a light, Father God, and the light is Jesus. We give you glory, Father God, as we celebrate the life of Sister Johnson. We give you glory, Father God, as we observe, Father God, not when it began and not when it ended, but what happened between the dots. We give you glory, Father God, for just having the opportunity to know her, to share with her, and to minister to you with her. Comfort, Father God. Lend your compassion and your love that never fails to this family. And we give you all glory and honor in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.
Hallelujah. We thank God for today. First of all, I would like to say, on behalf of the Thomas family, Johnson family, we want to thank you for all the cards and letters, prayers, phone calls, texts, and concerns for the family during this time of bereavement. Right about this time, Cassandra would be handing me my lifesaver and wishing me good luck. We had, through this COVID, we had so many good days. Even though it was funerals, it was good days. Amen. And she would always say, girl, I don't want no COVID. And we made it through it. Today I will read to you one card and three letters. The only reason we feel such profound loss is because we had such profound blessing. How sad we are now, but how lucky we were, and how fortunate we are still to have all the stories and experiences and memories we shared. Let us find peace in the past to carry our hearts forward. With deepest sympathy, Mount Zion Nurses Ministry. We will miss Cassandra dearly. To the family of Sister Cassandra Johnson, we, the membership of Mount Zion Baptist Church, Fredericksburg, wish to express our heartfelt sympathy in the homegoing of Sister Cassandra Johnson. Our hearts go out to you as you endure this loss. Yet we must not grieve without hope, for we wait for the day of great rejoicing when all God's children will gather and inherit the joy of heaven. I hope you can take comfort in the fact that Sister Cassandra Johnson is with God, now her Heavenly Father, we will continue to live in all our hearts and memories. Please take comfort in this passage from the book of Revelation, 21st chapter, verses 3 and 4. And I heard a loud voice from heaven saying, behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore, for the former things have passed away. Therefore, behalf of Pastor Butler and the entire Mount Zion Church family, we offer this letter as an expression of our deepest love and concerns to the Johnson family. I pray that God be your refuge and your strength, a very present help in this time of bereavement. The Mount Zion family is here for you emotionally, spiritually, and physically. With loving thoughts and sympathy, Reverend Carl A. Butler, Pastor, Terry Edwards, Church Clerk. My dearest friend, Cassandra, you were the first person that I met when I moved to Virginia, February 2004, and we have been very close friends ever since. I am still at a loss for words, but I know there was a reason that you were called home so soon. I have learned not to question our Heavenly Father, for he knows the plans that he has for us. We just need to trust in him. Amen. I will miss hearing your infectious laughter, spending just all holidays with you, attending church revivals, and during football season, watching the football games together. You were like family to me. You were the big sister that I never had. My sincere and deepest condolences to the entire family. My thoughts and prayers are with you. Each of you. May God keep you strong and united through this challenging time. Love you, sis. You will be forever etched in my memory. Tracy Reynolds, family friend, Dumfries, Virginia. To the family of Sister Cassandra Thomas Johnson, Romans 14, chapter 8 and 9. If we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord. Amen. For this is the very reason Christ died and returned to life, so that he might be the Lord of both the dead and the living. When God created Cassandra Thomas Johnson, he created a unique person. Through her trials and tribulations, she remained steadfast and unmovable for Christ and to the nurses' ministry. Her presence at Mount Zion Baptist Church will be missed. She had her unique way of loving each person she greeted. Her temperature checks were full of love, and her lifesaver candy was for the ones that she truly loved. So if you were given candy before, during, or after service, you were one that she really loved. Each time Mount Zion called, Cassandra answered yes. And on May 5th, 2021, God called, and Cassandra answered yes. God reached in and grabbed her from the front door of this branch of Zion. We loved her and depended on her so much, but we must remember that she belonged to God. He placed her here in 2003. He called her home in 2021. This is a calling that we all must answer. Whereas in the providence of God, he has brought to a close the life of our own Sister Cassandra Johnson, Reverend Dr. Alfred Jones, Jr., officers and members of Mount Zion Baptist Church, Triangle, Virginia, feel that it is befitting to express their sympathy to the entire Johnson family. We commend you to him who knoweth best and will always do right. Sean, we are so sorry for the loss of your mother. You have our sincere prayers. Therefore, be it resolved, when it is all over, we would like you to remember, in case there's a time when you just need some cheer, in case there is a problem you would like us to hear, in case there's a favor you would like us to do, we are here if you need us to help see you through. Humbly submitted on this 29th day of May, 2021, Reverend Dr. Alfred Jones, Jr., Pastor, Sister Wanda Mickens, Church Clerk. Thank you.
Good morning. First, giving honor to God, Pastor Jones, clergy, family, good morning. At this time, I'd like to ask my fellow deacons to please stand where you are. And on behalf of our deacons, I just wanted you to know, family, Sister Johnson was a faithful and hardworking member of Mount Zion. Her smile and her giving spirit will definitely be missed. We recognize that as mere mortals, there's nothing we can say to ease your pain. And therefore, we're going to do as we would ask you to do. Look to the words of Jesus himself, who said, "Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also." Family, we know that, again, we want to express our sincerest condolences, and we want you to know that we're here for whatever you need, not only today, but in the many days to come. Be blessed. Thank you, deacons.
Amen. I want to introduce to you right now a close friend and brother. To me, he is one of the best interpreters of song and spoken word. My friend, Pastor Marvin Winans. Be blessed.
everybody.
Say amen.
God
has spoken.
So let the church,
say
church, say amen. God has spoken. Let the church say amen. At this time, we're going to have some reflections. We're going to ask Sister Lacey Easter and Deacon Daryl Rollins, Robertson brother, to come at this time.
To God. My name is Sister Issa, and I came here in the name of Jesus. Amen. Just to give honor and glory to my Lord and Savior. Father God, I thank you, Pastor, for allowing me to be here. I thank everyone. This is not a time to moan. It's a time to rejoice. Amen. I can truly say hallelujah, glory to God, because my sister got her wings. She is free at last. If it was up to her, she would not want to come back. I see her in the name and just say, girl, you know what? I am good. I won't come back. But when I do, I will come only in a spirit, in the name of Jesus. I won't take long, but I am honored to know her. My honor and my glory goes to Mr. Harris and the family and her beautiful grandchildren, because she loved you guys more than life. She always talked about her son and her beautiful little angels, her granddaughter and her grandson. So I won't be long. I thank God for being here. And one day I will be where she is. But only way I can do that is in the name of Jesus. Amen. So I thank God. She's well known and she will be well missed in the name of Jesus. So I give honor and glory to everyone. Hallelujah!
First, giving honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, Pastor Jones, the pulpit, and to the family. We love you. I'm Deacon Robinson. I'm the spiritual advisor for the nurses ministry, and that's why I stand here. Because there's so many people in this church that have testimony of who Sandra is. I couldn't even deal with that. But I'm standing in the place of the for the nurses. I'm speaking for the nurses. And it's just a privilege and an honor to be the spiritual advisor for the nurses. These ladies have a spirit that would blow your mind. I get to see the interactions that are outside of the church and how they love on each other and they care for each other the same way that they care for us when we're here. And Sister Cassandra is special amongst the special. Amen. She was something special. And whoever wrote this, it really captures it. If you look at the pictures and everything that's there and read about, that's who she was. She was someone special. And she was always available. And as I was reading this, I have a reflection for myself. Because, you know, very seldom when we come to the funeral of someone who's in our ministries, I very seldom see anyone that's younger than me. So it's a reflection to me. Hey, she was ready. She's been working for the Lord, and the Lord said, it's time for you to come on home. And all of us that are laboring for the Lord, when the Lord is ready, he's going to call us the same way. For those who are don't know the Lord. If there's anybody here that don't know the Lord, now's the time to get with you. Amen. Now's the time to know. Your mother was very special. She was special to us. I know she was special in your life, but she was special in God's hand as well. She's home with the Lord. Be blessed. If we can ever help you, just reach out to us. We're here for you. We love you. God bless.
Suddenly we thank Sister Lacey and Deacon Robinson for the words of comfort to this family. We thank you so much. At this time, we're going to turn to the obituary. We're going to read it silently. And right after the obituary, the praise team will give us a selection, and then we will do the eulogy. Amen.
Transition. Thank you. Now listen at this. When your journey is completed, and to God you have been true.
Can have power when we hold on to God's unchanging hand. Now we all know that months will change, styles will change, years will change. Even human beings change. But the scripture says that Jesus Christ is the same today that he was yesterday. Simply suggests that he doesn't change. Aren't you happy about that? Give God a praise because he does not change. Now you know, that there are some members in your church that die. And you have to stay up all night and all day searching for something to say. From one book to another, from one scripture to another. And sometimes you say to yourself, should I say this or should I not say this? But not so with Cassandra. I told Reverend Brown this morning, I said, hey, last time I saw her alive. Now, I don't know why she decided to do this on this particular Sunday. She came all the way into my office and checked my temperature. And then after she checked my temperature, she looked at me and she said, she always called me Reverend Joe. She said, Reverend Joan, I love you. And went on about her business. That's the last time I saw her alive. Brothers and sisters, I'm just going to talk about Cassandra. I'm not going to preach no sermon. Because when Cassandra served as a nurse at the school, every Sunday she preached her own eulogy. So I'm going to just say a few words. I got a strange text. Go to me. Go with me, brother, to the book of Revelation. I know we don't like to deal with Revelation. We preach from every book in the Bible. But when it comes to Revelation, I don't know whether we're scared or what, but I see a scripture here that fit Cassandra. Revelation chapter 2. Revelation chapter 2 and verse 10. And it read thus there. He said, fear none of those things which you shall suffer. He said, behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison that you may be tried. And you shall have tribulation 10 days. But somebody ought to give God praise. He said, be thou faithful unto death. And I will give you a crown of life. Verse 11 says, he who has an ear, let them hear what the Spirit says unto the church. And not talking to this building. Come on, preacher. But he's talking to the church. And all of us that have accepted Jesus as our Savior, we are the church. So take your seat, just a few minutes. I promise you it won't be long, because I don't have to be here a long time to preach. I want to talk about this subject, or from this subject. She was faithful. Now, I wish I could say that about everybody that profess to be a part of the body of Christ. Wouldn't it be nice that if I could say everybody that connected to the body of Christ was faithful? We live in a world where people will accept positions, but they are not faithful. In other words, they do it on their terms. They serve God. On that. They serve him when they feel like it. But Cassandra was not that way. She loved. Can I just talk about her? She loved her job. And you may say, but Pastor, how do you know she loved? She loved the job. Because I can't remember but one time in the whole time that she'd been members of this church that she ever changed her uniform. Every time I saw her, she was in her work clothes. She was on duty whenever she was called. Some people have to be call to do that job. And even when you call them, they still don't want to come. But Cassandra did not wait for a call. She knew her job. What was her job? She was a caretaker. She looked out for people. Not only here at the church, but she went around the county. And see, you really got to love your job in order to take care of sick people. Because some of us don't want to take care of well people. But you really got to be loved. You really got to love your job in order to take care. She would share with me sometime the people that she took care of. And apparently, she didn't do her job halfway because the people loved her. Because see, when you are good to people, when you love your job, people will know it beside you. She would faith. Now, let me tell you what she was faithful at. She was faithful, first of all, to herself. Because a lot of us are not faithful to ourselves. We allow ourselves to keep us out of the work that God has in store for us. You remember that Jesus said, if you're going to be my disciples, the first thing you got to do, you got to get rid of self. Too many of us are stuck on self. Cassandra wasn't stuck on herself. She was faithful. She realized that the only way that she could be an effective servant, and that's all we, any of us who are in here that are working for the Lord, that's all you are, just a servant. I don't care what your position may be, from the pulpit to the door, we're just servants, that's all. And I don't know about you, but every now and then, I just thank God that he allowed me to be a servant in the army of the Lord. I'm not choosy about what position he put me in. Whatever position you have for me, I can say it like Isaiah said, here am I. She was faithful to herself. Pastor, how can you say that? She removed herself out of the way. And brothers and sisters, I don't want to tell somebody here today, if you're going to work in this Christian army, you got to get rid of self. Because I don't know about you, but I always tell people, self is always right and everybody else is wrong. She wasn't stuck on herself. And you know what? She didn't care what you say about her. She didn't care whether you like her or not. It was all right because she knew who she was working for. She wasn't working for you and I, but she was working. And that was a difference when you know who you're working for. See, because when you work for God, you can't go when you wanna. Sometimes you don't feel like going. But you know that your assignment calls for you. She was faithful. I know sometimes she didn't even work by the schedule. Sometimes she'd tell me, she'd say, Pastor, I'm out of schedule this morning, but I'm here. I can't even get some people on schedule. She loved. Anytime you're doing something you don't like, you need to find another job. Because not only will you mess up the job, you'll mess up everybody that's around you. She was faithful to herself. I got to move on. Then she was faithful to her ministry. Y'all know I'm right about it. You didn't have to beg Cassandra to do something. She was always and all the time ready. She was faithful to her ministry. And God knows I wish that we had more people like that. Sometimes I ask God. As a pastor, sometimes I ask God. Sometimes I ask God, and I even ask him. I say, God, why you take my good people? I said, why would you just take her like that? God said, she belongs to me. And I am God. I have the power. Yeah. do whatever. Then he tells me, he said, well, look, I take the ones who are ready to go. And those who are not ready, I leave them here to get ready. Hallelujah. Finally, she was faithful not only to herself and not only to her ministry, but she was faithful to God. Now the scripture says that we must be that faithful unto death. Didn't it say? He didn't say be that faithful till I get tired. Be that faithful until somebody make me angry. Until somebody cross my path. But the Bible said, be thou faithful. There's a difference between faithful unto and faithful until. Many of us in church, we are faithful until, but we are not faithful until. I wish I had a praying church. You see, when you're faithful until, you're not working for man. I don't care what they say. I don't care how they talk about me. I don't care whether they like me or not. As long as I know that God is on my side. And the scripture says, if God be for you, who can be against you? She was faithful to her God. Why was she faithful to her God? Because she knew that this day was coming. I wonder, do all of you in here know that you're going to die? I don't care what type of insurance company you have. I don't care what protection you have. It really doesn't matter. Death is coming to everybody. The scripture said it is appointed unto man to die, and after death, the judgment. All y'all in here, y'all got appointment. From the pulpit to the door, all of us got a appointed time to die. And I'm glad I don't know. Because a lot of us would be saved if we knew. But Christ makes it and fix it in such a way that you have an opportunity to accept me or reject me. She was faithful to her God because she knew that she had an appointment with God. Now, I'm going to tell you this, and then I'm going to take my seat. You can have a doctor's appointment and break it. I know I had one last weekend. I had something to do, and I called the doctor because I didn't want to pay the $50. Because if you don't call them in time, you have to pay from $40 to $50 because you broke your appointment. Am I right about it? So I call and I told them, I said, I can't make it. They said, well, when? They said, well, we don't have no more appointments until July. I said, that's all right. I take it when you can give it to me. But I can't deal with Jesus like that. See, I don't know when he's going to show up. But the scripture says that we must be ready when he showed up. And I stopped by here to tell somebody today, get your house in order. Because Samuel was just 57. You see, you don't have a guarantee how long you're going to live. But I want to tell you, if you got some skeletons in your closet, clean them out. Get your life ready. Because just as so I'm standing here, some glad morning when this life is over, we're going to get out of here. And I don't know about you, but I made up my mind that I want to see Jesus who died for me and rose and made it possible that I can spend eternity with him. Because he said in John chapter 14, he said, let not your heart be troubled. If you believe in me, believe also in God. Because in my Father's house, there are many mansions. And if it were not so, I would not have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I'm going to come back and receive you unto myself. I don't know how long it will be, but one thing I do know, that when he comes, I want to be ready to go home and be with the Lord. She was faithful to herself. She was faithful to her ministry. And she was faithful to her God. Now, I don't know about you, but I see again. Now, somebody in here won't see her again. Because the only way that you can see her again, you got to get your life. You got to get your life right. And this book tells me how I can get my life. Romans 10:9 said, if you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God has raised Jesus from the dead, thou shalt be saved. If you're saved, you'll see again. May God bless you today. May heaven smile upon you. Father God, we thank you for the life of Cassandra. Cassandra, we thank you for all of the days that she run down these aisles, passing out tissues. All of those times she would run around, checking temperature. Make sure that everything was in order. Thank you for that, God. Bless her son. She loved her son. She would always tell us about her son. God prop him up on every lean and side. Help him, God. Make him, mold him, shape him what you want him to be. That he can see mama in that great getting up. She loved her grandchildren. She'd bring him to church with the Lord. You know she did. Thank you for that. Keep us in your care. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Tim, before we go or take this body to the grave, we want to just extend the hymn of invitation to the unsaved. Maybe somebody just stumbled up in here today. I want you to know you can be saved right now. If you don't know Christ as your Savior, let him come in your life. We're going to sing just one verse. If you hear unsaved in church, raise your hand and one of these deacons will come get you. Praise. Everybody, all praise. Oh, you ought to pray. Jesus, Jesus, my blessed Savior. You are in your word and your word. Oh, Lord, yeah. From the rising until the glory now. Lord, have mercy. Jesus, you were there. Lord, you were there. Oh, Lord, Lord, how much I just gotta praise you, Lord. Jesus, Jesus, blessed Savior. God bless you. At this time, y'all may be seated. The mortician is going to come. My understanding that we're going to commit the body right here. It is, the weather is not the best. And we're going to commit the body. Going to ask the family, if you don't mind, stay here in the sanctuary. And they will take it up. And they will close the grave. Put the flowers. And then you can come. Is that all right? Okay. Shall we all stand? For as much as it has pleased the Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of the world the soul of our deceased sister, Cassandra Thomas Johnson, I now therefore commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes and dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection in the last days, in the life of the world to come. Through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, at whose second cometh, to glory, to match, and to judge the world. The earth and the sea shall give up their dead, and those corruptible bodies that sleep in him shall be changed and made likened unto his own glory. Whereby he's able to subdue all things unto himself. John said, I heard a voice from heaven saying, blessed are the dead who dies in the Lord. So said the Spirit, for they rest from their labor. Father, we thank you. We pray, God, that as we conclude this service, that your Holy Spirit would abide with us. Let me personally thank you, God, for allowing Cassandra and my path to cross. Thank you for putting her in my life. And not only putting her in my life, but putting her in the members of Mount Zion. She's with you now, Lord. She's not looking down, but she's with you. Keep her, God, until we get there. Because one of these days, we all will meet there. And we'll crown him King of Kings and Lord of Lords. In Jesus' name. And now may the grace of God, our Father, be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Let the church say amen.
Sing this song. Sing this song.
Let the church say God has spoken, so let the church say amen. Oh, let the church say amen. Let the church. So let the church say amen. Oh, let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. God has spoken. So let the church say amen. Oh, praise team, help me sing it.
Let the church
make this your response. said it.
Let the church say it.
Oh, here's what you gotta do. What you gotta do. Make this your response.
Amen.
To whatever God says, from the healing of your body, oh, to the raising of it. Yes, God.
Amen.
How your soul is reeling.